there, it's Jayne here and welcome back to my channel. So I'm back with another video and today we are chit-chatting on savings versus investments. But before I go any further, click the subscribe button, okay? Click that button and click the notifications bell so you get notified every single time I have a new video up. So I asked on Instagram for people to send me a money related question and I got this question from Kappa. He said, is it better to save money long term in a savings account or to invest it? For example, should I put a 500 kwacha in a savings account or invest that into some kind of business or something? The savings in the bank has no real goal. Just don't want to touch it for at least 3 years. So I'm going to answer this question in basically two parts. Part one is the crux of it. I want to ask first, do you have your opportunity fund / emergency fund sorted? So what that is a pot of money, say it's sitting somewhere in your savings, that is enough to cover you between 3 months to 6 months if anything happened and you were not able to earn any more money. That's your emergency fund or opportunity fund, as I like to call it. So this is how you calculate your emergency fund. You look at your monthly expenses. So that's housing, rent, transport, food, utilities, bills, that sort of thing. You put that, you calculate how much each of those cost you per month and then find the total. Keep in mind that you are not adding any luxuries here, okay? So if you pay for both Netflix and DSTV, then you're not calculating those. You don't need those to live. You can live without them. So you'd remove the, you remove the wants and just have the needs. And that's how much you spend per month. So once you figure out what that number is, you then multiply that by 3 months and then by 6 months. So let's say your monthly needs amount up to 3,000 kwacha. So for 3 months, it means you need 9,000 kwacha. For 6 months, it means you need 18,000 kwacha. If you don't have that 18,000 kwacha sitting in somewhere, in a fund somewhere waiting for you, just chilling, giving you assurance and security, then that's what you need to do first. So start putting your 500 kwachas towards that every month. Build up that fund, okay? If you have the 18,000 kwacha sitting, then you can then start considering investing that 500 kwacha towards growing it. And it's important to note why we say only 3 to 6 months. Because remember, in Zambia, our inflation rate is very high. If I'm not mistaken, at this point, it should be even up towards the 15%, right? A savings account is not giving you 15%. So if you have money more than 6 months sitting in a savings account, then you're losing money to inflation, okay? What you could do with your money today is going to be less than what you'll be able to do with your money in December or in 2021. So that's why the 6 months only, okay? So that's the first bit of it. Build your emergency opportunity fund. It's important to also have it as an opportunity fund because one of the things we've noted from the people who have done well and who have succeeded in the past is that they're able to access amounts of money to invest quickly. So that's why it's important to have that fund. Because if there's a business opportunity that pops up and you have opportunity to invest, then you can reach into that and invest it. So this is why I call it an opportunity fund. Now, that's the first bit of it. So the second bit of it is very dangerous not to have a goal for your money, okay? It's possible for you to save 500 kwacha every month for what, 3 years? But if you don't have a goal for that money, after 3 years, you are going to blow it randomly. And I'm speaking from experience. And I'm speaking from observation. We know these people who are in savings groups where they save a large amount of money. And then at the end of the year, they do their share out. They take this money and they blow it. Why is it possible to blow this money? Because you have no goal for it. So the goal was to save it for 3 years. You saved it for 3 years and then what? Nothing. So you feel like, oh, I can go on holiday, or oh, I can buy this and that. So you want to have a goal always for your money. You want to be able to tell it what to do. You want to be able to tell it where to go and how to work for you. Okay. Another thing you must consider when you're thinking about building your emergency savings is also putting it somewhere where it can earn something for you. So in a savings account, it might not be as high of an interest, but consider putting that money into a recurring fixed deposit. So 30 days recurring. So you can put your 500 kwacha in a fixed deposit on the 1st of July and it revolves up to the 30th of July. Come so that it ends. So come 30th of July, you can add another 500 to that with the interest accrued and roll it over into another 30 days. Money is growing slightly versus just leaving it in a standard savings account, because fixed deposits have a relatively higher level of interest that it accrues. So that is my advice on your 500 kwacha per month, whether you should save it versus whether you should invest it. So let me know what you think in the comments below. Do you think this has made sense? Do you feel like you should invest it, or do you feel like you should save it? Comment below, let me know what you think. Also, do not forget to like, subscribe and share this video with all your people. Until next time.